wondered, what makes humans different from the other animals? How we are so special than the other animals? What it could be? Is it our ability of thinking, or probably using our fingers, which makes us craftsmen? Or is it our ability to communicate in a completely different way than the other animals? Hello everyone, this is Teacher Shraddha, and today we are going to continue with our topic, Evolution of Men. Now, in case if you have not seen the previous video, please go and watch that, because this is going to be a continuation, the second lesson, the second part of the first lesson. Alright, so quickly let's have a recap of what we had done for the previous lesson. Now, as you can see on the screen, there is some saying by Charles Darwin, it is not that the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent that survives, but it is the one that is the most adaptable to change. Now, we had discussed this in the previous video lesson, and I really would like to know what you all have to say about it. The other things what we discussed, what we should know. We discussed about formation of our planet. How many ages it took for our planet to actually be what it is today. Also, it took ages, billions of years, just to take a formation, to form mountains, continents. We also learned about the supercontinent. It is believed that the continents were not existing at a point of a time. It was just one continent which was called as a supercontinent, and over a period of time these continents moved. They moved away, and that's how we have continents and oceans. There were a lot of volcanic eruptions which happened. Then also the ice ages which our planet experienced. Now, ice ages also brought a lot of change in our environment. Even the living beings which were there, they were also affected because of ice age. They had to migrate. They had to get adapted to different things because of change of climatic change, atmospheric change, etc. Early life on the planet. We discussed this as well. How the life came in on the planet. How the oxygen was formed, which allowed lot different organisms to form. And right from a single cellular to multicellular, and then the invertebrates, vertebrates, and then the mammals, they all were formed. And of course, as the time went on, they migrated to different places and adapted to different lifestyles, different diet, etc., which brought a lot of change in them. And today they are existing, some of the species, but they are completely different species. They were not the same what they were. And the theory of evolution. We learned about theory of evolution which Charles Darwin came with, and which opened up, you know, a way for many more theories. It changed the way people looked at life, the people looked at biology. A lot of more theories also came in along with this. And we also saw what was a natural selection, which means it was focused that usually when a human being evolves, he evolves so that he can get adapted to the present environment. Like even today, we are evolving. So let's continue and see how amazing we are, humans are, okay, and how we evolved over the period of time. We also saw sources, which was the first video which I had made. Sources through which we come to know about the different prehistory. One of the important sources was the fossils, which we had discussed. Alright, now let's continue with the remaining part. Now, as we said, that the humans, due to ice ages, different species, those who were not able to adapt to the environment, they got extinct. They are no longer existing now, and those who got adapted to it, they are still living, and one of the species is called as primate. Now, what are primates? Basically, we humans belong to this group. Along with us, we have chimpanzees, orangutan, all this are primate. So basically primates are a species which lives on tree. And something which makes us different from the other animal is also our opposable thumb. That is the thumb which we are using. Basically this thumb, it's called as opposable probably because it can touch the fingers. Now why we use this? We use this to, it helps us to grasp. So when these primates were living on the tree, they used the fingers, thumb to grasp the things, to jump from one branch to the other branch and so on. After some period of time, some primates are believed to come down from the tree and they started using their hind legs, that means the legs which are behind, to stand. So which probably helped them to see what is there far. So probably some predators or some animals, some other animals, they wanted to see what was there. So they started walking on those legs. Now, and that's how homos came in. So basically homos are men. Now these homos, we are going to divide this in three different things. Like there are many more species which came in, like different part of the world saw different species. Okay, now how do we know this, that these are different species? From again, it's all about whatever fossils we get. So depending on the fossils are studied by expert people which are called as paleontologists, and they find about them, they really go into detail, depth, and they find about it, and then they categorize these things into different species. Now the first species what I'm going to tell you quickly about is Homo habilis. Now these people, you can call it as an early man, and they lived by scavenging animals and birds for food. Now, it was not that easy as well, right? Because some animals are quite stronger than us humans, and these people, they had to compete with them for food. But these people had a secret weapon. What was that? It was stone tools. So it is believed that these people had, they had started making stone tools. Now a core chopper was one of their main stone tool which probably they used to chop the animal or fruit or a branch or whatever. Okay, and these, that's why since they were using stone tools, they were called as handymen. Now these were from Africa. It's believed that they were found in African region, and that was 2 million years ago. The next species is Homo erectus. Now this is one of the species which is known to be there for quite a long period of time on the planet Earth. Now Homo erectus is one of the first species which is believed to stand straight and walk. He's also known as upright man. Alright, so these people, these Homo erectus, they lived around 1.3 million years ago, and again from Africa, they inhabited in Africa, and from Africa they are believed to move from there. Okay, now where do they go? See, look at this map. Now if you see from Africa, it is believed that these people must have walked. Now it didn't happen in few years, it took them thousands of years to do that. So from Africa, probably they moved to Asia, and here in Indonesia, there is an island called as Java. So some of the fossils were found in Java region, and that's why the fossils which were found there, it was called as a Java man. So these are also called as Java men. Again from here, they are believed to move to China, wherein they are called as a Peking man. So this is the place. Now there are no evidences that these people must have moved to Europe. Alright, so here probably they must have moved because due to ice age, probably the water level was low and they could move. But there are no other evidence this people were, you know, they traveled somewhere else also. So this is about Homo erectus. Also, these people were believed to use fire. All Alright, so this is about Homo erectus. Next we go to Homo sapiens. Now these were even more developed people with, you know, more better characteristics. The brains were, the capacity of the brain was much more than the previous ones. They had a high forehead and small teeth, whereas the previous ones, if you see Homo habilis, they had a huge teeth. Alright, and even they did not have chin, but these people had defined chin just like how kind of we have today. They had, they also are believed to be using sophisticated tools, okay, not just normal stone tools, but sophisticated tools, better tools, sharpened ones, and also they were believed to be using some kind of language to communicate. Alright, now if here you can see how the skull was right from the first 2-3 million years ago till the to present. So if you see, that's how the skull and the brain also developed. So it just developed over the years. Alright, now let's come to one of our feature which we have, humans have, which differentiates us from the other animal, and that was the power of speech. Now, why our speech is so powerful? Humans can speak, we can communicate in different ways, like we can express our thoughts. Right now I'm giving you some information, I'm talking, that is also a way of communicating. We can ask questions, we can give orders, we can share a lot of information, which other animals cannot do. Other animals, they communicate, but they can only communicate on immediate thing, like probably food or threat or danger or something like that. So this differentiates us from the other animals. Now, how do you think this language must have developed? Now, later we have another chapter on communications where we are going to discuss about this communication in detail. But how do you think it must have started? Just maybe some cavemen got together and they decided, okay, we are going to form some language today, and they had a kind of a seminar and they started with their language. Is it that way? No. It didn't happen then. Languages started by just, you know, some early man by grunting, making some kind of sounds, by crying out or hooting, and then it got developed slowly and slowly. So as the people, they moved. They were basically moving from one place to the other place. So maybe a group, they must have formed some kind of language, some kind of sound, and when they moved from the other place, it was taken with them, which the other people who were closer to them got influenced with. That's why if you see, some languages are connected, you know, they have something similar in them. So maybe over thousands of years, over the period of years, it got developed, and today what we call them are languages. But probably they got derived from one main language. And it's also believed that early men also used sign languages. Alright? So they used sign languages, and which also got evolved. Alright. The next one we see is the other thing, what important feature is hand. Like earlier I said, we have flexible hands which are used by the early men to make tools. The tools were one of the main things which humans had at that time to fight animals, or even it made us craftsmen. The earlier men also made a lot of artifacts. You know, as the brain developed, all these things came in. Okay, as the brain developed, man started making use of hands. What I can do next? Okay, let's try this. So, the grasping or grabbing or grooming, all these things happen with the development of our fingers, development with our hands, and of course our thumbs. Okay, now, overall, the different species are again put in different groups. We already discussed some of the species. These are subspecies of those which I'm just going to explain you. So we have Ramathipicus, Australopithecus, Gizanthropus, Sinanthropus, Neanderthal man, and Cro-Magnon man. Now let's see what these are. First one, Ramathipicus. Now this species believed to live almost 12 to 14 million years ago. And of course, these fossils were found in North India and East Africa. These were very early men, which probably they were not even walking properly like men. Australopithecus, now these are supposed to inhabit in Africa, and they are believed that they were walking on two legs. Now, if you remember, if you all have seen the first video where I discussed about fossils, I also discussed about a fossil called as Lucy, which was the oldest fossil we found of our ancestor. Now, this Lucy belonged to this species, Australopithecus. They had large teeth and jaws and a small skull structure, and just like ape. Dizanthropus, now these were also discovered somewhere in 1959. The fossils were discovered in Tanzania, and they also had a gigantic teeth, huge teeth, small brains, flat face, and these kind of species mostly survived on nuts, seeds, worms, this kind of things, roots, and that's why they were called as nutcracker men. Next is, I'm taking the two species together. Now these both, Pithecanthropus and Sinanthropus, these both belong to Homo erectus group. Now we have already discussed what was Homo erectus group. These were the first people who could stand upright. Now one, as I had already mentioned, was found in Java, Indonesia, and the other one, Beijing. These were slightly different, though they belong to Homo erectus group. Next is Neanderthal species. Now this species basically was a mixture of a little bit of erectus and more of a Homo sapiens, that is the developed man, but not fully developed. Now some of the features of this were like, of course, this fossils were found in Neander Valley. Now there was a huge huge number of fossils were found in this valley, and that's why they were called as Neanderthal men. They are almost like Homo sapiens, and they used sophisticated technology along with the stone tools. They also were the first species which used bone tools. They also used bone to make ornaments. If you can see the ornaments, there is a picture. This kind of ornaments they made, and they used to wear them. So that shows, you know, they were even more developed. Also, they stayed in caves which were built, and they had this way of staying in a group. So they were quite social people. Also, it's believed that these people would treat injuries using medicinal plants. That means they had some knowledge about plants too. They used fire and also used different cooking techniques like roasting, boiling, smoking, etc. Also, the cave paintings which are found in Spain are believed to be done by Neanderthals. So these were the people who also had art, you know, they started painting. So they lived for something more than just living. And also they had a kind of a way to communicate. So probably some kind of language they had. So this is about Neanderthals. And next one is Cro-Magnon. These are basically, this species belongs to Homo sapiens, which are well-developed human. This, they stayed around 35,000 to 45,000 years ago, and they had powerful bodies. You know, the muscles were built up and they were strong. They had straight forehead, face was short and wide with a large chin. So probably just like what we look today. Their brain was slightly larger than the humans today, and they hunted big animals they would hunt, and for that they used tools like spears and javelin. So that means they had even more advanced tools. Their life was more of nomadic, meaning they moved from one place to the other, maybe in search of food or probably for shelter. So this is about the different species. Now we are almost at the end of the chapter, and I would like to do a small, you to do a small activity, a fun activity. Okay, I have just given an activity there. This is just fun activity, so you don't have to do it in the book or submit it to me. It's just for you to know how important our thumb is. So you have to do this activities. For that, what you have to do first is just tape your thumb so that you don't use it. Alright, so whatever activities are given, you have to just use your four fingers and do it. So some of the activities are, you have to write your name with pencil, but don't use the thumb. Put a sock and a shoe. Open a door using a knob. Brush or comb your hair. So there are a list of activities which I have given you. You have to try it out. Alright, so you can also add your own activities and see whether you can do it or no. And then make a small chart of which activity took longer than using, you could have done it using thumb. So here it is, took longer or was more difficult without using thumb, about the same without thumb, or you couldn't do the activity at all. Now you can add some more, whatever you think of. Alright, so have fun with this activity and read your lesson after watching this video. Thank you and bye-bye.